الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، أعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا، يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، خير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، فإن كل محدثات بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار، وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. greet you all with the greeting of Islam. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah be with you all. Continuing reading and translating and explaining from the book عظمت الإسلام, The Greatness and the Beauty of Islam by Mahmoud Mahdi al-Istanbuli. And why I selected this subject? Because the more that you know about the beauty of Islam and the reality of Islam and the virtues of Islam, the more you love it, the more you hold fast to it, the more that you want to talk about it, the more that you give da'wah towards it. Loving Islam, it have to be something that in our heart, so we could not see any replacement for Islam in our life, in its adab, in its customer, in its belief, in everything. The more that we see the beauty of Islam, the more we love Islam. The more you love Islam, the more that you will adopt Islam in your life. Islam is the greatest thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to us. Islam is the way that Allah had to choose and select for mankind. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala intends all good for us. Therefore, Allah gave us Islam. And Allah told us, إِنَّ الدِّينَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامِ. Indeed, the religion in the sight of Allah is Islam, total submission and total surrender to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't accept any other way to Him. Not Christianity, no Buddhism, no any other ways that people may inherit, or that the philosophy that may bring to themselves and to others. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us that وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِي غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا فَلَنْ يُقْبَلَ مِنْهُ وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. That whosoever choose other way than Islam is not going to be accepted from him, and he, in the hereafter, he or she will be among the losers. So to get out of being among the losers, to be among the winners, that you have to adopt Islam. Islam is the greatest gift and the greatest blessing that Allah gives to mankind. If we really can feel the importance of Islam, Islam will be dearer to us more than our sight, our hearing, the money, the children, everything. It is a ni'mah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. What ni'mas of Allah is talking about here is this deen, this Islam is the relationship between us and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's what keep us connected to Allah. This what keeps us, you understand, on the sirat al-mustaqim. You say, today I had completed the religion for you. And I had perfected my favor upon you. What favor that Allah gave us that became the highest of all gifts is Islam. And he said, and I'm pleased with Islam as a way of life for you. So without Islam, we are nothing. And the more that we adopt Islam in our life, the more that we loved by Allah, the more that we get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We could not get closer to Allah by philosophy or by thinking or by ideas or mankind made laws and ideology, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمُ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا. So Allah is pleased with Islam as a way of life for us in everything. So if Allah is pleased with it, how we can try to choose something different or allow somebody to choose something different from for us? In this book, the Shaykh Rahmatullah alayhi is saying, Al-Islam intisar al-tawheed ala al-shirk. Islam is the victory of Tawheed, oneness of Allah, over shirk, polytheism, and partnership. Even if this shirk is a hidden shirk. Islam provides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have or set Allah distant away from having equal or similar. This is something very important. Islam tells us, giving us the proper understanding about the Ilah, about the God, that there is no equal to Him, there is no similarity to Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, by adopting Islam, now we had won the battle against shirk, against Trinity, against polytheism. التوحيد معناه إفراد الإله بالعبودية. توحيد مؤلس of Allah means single Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with all form of worship. The salah is for Allah, the fasting for Allah, the reading and the giving and the taking is for Allah. So this, what is Islam, is about Tawheed. And what is Tawheed? To bring in everything into one. Your devotion, your fear, your love, your submission, to bring it to Allah and Allah alone. The fear is not fearing the jinn or the angels or the human being or the mother nature. Your total fear is from Allah. Your total love is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this will give the human being and mankind freedom. So you exchanging, you making exchange, like you go to the marketplace, you give money and you take a product. So you give Tawheed, you receive freedom. That means the people who are not having Tawheed, they are a slave. And I'm sure you heard this hadith many times, that the Prophet ﷺ said, ruined, doomed, slave of the dinar, dollar, money, doomed loser is the slave of the suit and the garment. So people have a different form of slavery in their life. Some people are slave of the society. Some people are a slave of themselves. And some people are the slaves of their mind. They see their mind greater. And even they start taught that you are God. You're capable to do this. And instead of using Allah's blessings and Allah's favor and see the ni'mah of Allah upon you, now you start to see yourself to be greater. And you feel that you are the creator. You're the one who can make things happen. But when you give slavery to Allah and to Allah alone, now you're receiving freedom from the king, from the president, from the people, from all kind of ideology that man-made ideology. You be a free person because you only fear Allah. Because you only obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in total submission and total surrender to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. A human being and mankind could not have a real freedom on the earth unless they gave ubudiyya and slavery to Allah. So they did not see the king or the president or the governor as the ilah. Okay? They see him to be one to serve in Allah's kingdom, to facilitate the laws of Allah. But he doesn't. He or they. It can be one person, what you call as a dictatorship, or it can be a group, like you say the Congress as example, okay? Or the ruling party. They have different names, okay? But still worshiping a man, giving a man a total right of running their life. When to live, where to live, how to live, what you can wear, what you could not wear, what you can say, what you could not say. This is wrong. So the more that you give ubudiyya, slavery to Allah, that the more you have freedom. Even if you could not do anything, but you are free in your heart. You're free in your mind. You know that you only belong to Allah. And everything in the hand of Allah is not in the hand of the people. You don't depend on the people and fear them because your loaf of bread. You know that your loaf of bread been decreed by Allah and it come to you in the right time which Allah had decreed it for you. Doesn't matter if the people put you in jail or people leave you walking in the street. You're still knowing and believing it. Not only knowing, a belief, strong belief, that your sustenance in the hand of Allah and in Allah alone. And that your life span is in Allah's hand and Allah's hand alone. People like nothing. But when you're going to get this security in your heart and this peace in your heart, the more you give yourself to Allah, the more that you will feel it in your life, the more you have ease in your life. So there is no one to be worshipped in reality and in the true sense other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that the fear, all the fear is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They maybe even put the rope around a person's neck and they're going to count to 10. To take his life, like they hang him nowadays, okay? But he will know that this robe is not going to get around his neck unless Allah had permitted. But he doesn't fear the people. He will say the truth. And they will stand firm with the truth regardless. And we can see in the Quran a lot of stories about it. Even women, even children. Okay? As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us in Surah Al-Buruj. Okay? واليوم الموعود وشاهد ومشهود قتل أصحاب الأخدود. They dig ditch in the ground. They kindle a big fire. And everybody passed by these people. You believe in God or you believe in the king? Now you have a choice. Even to such a woman carrying her baby come. And now she sees a fire. But she's worried about her child. Her love for Allah and her fear for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was more greater than anything. But being a mother, her heart go to her child. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enabled the child to speak and say, mother, don't worry about it. You're in the truth. Go ahead. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about me. Today you understand, you see how people, they give up their belief because some money, because of position. They turn colors. Why? Because they don't have the real belief in Allah. They don't have the real tawheed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So being saying la ilaha illallah, that you fear none more than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us in Quran, Surah number 47, verse number 19. فَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Get to know that there is no true ilah, there is no true God other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Did we get this ilm? Did we get this knowledge? Did we have this certainty? Allah wants us to get to know, فَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ, that there is no deity, no mighty, no power except by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He knew about all this kind of things that people make and how people adopt things, because sometimes people, they impose themselves in people's life to be like gods. Okay? And sometimes the people elevate them and make out of them gods. Okay? But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us, and we need to reflect in this Quran about these verses. This surah number 22. Would you check, Habib, if I'm giving the verse first or the surah first? Surah number 22. Is it Surah Al-Hajj, pilgrimage? Okay, so, okay. Surah number 22, verse number 73. And listen to this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ تَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ لَنْ يَخْلُقُوا ذُبَابًا وَلَوْ اجْتَمَعُوا لَهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is showing you that reality of ilah. What does it ilah mean? He's the creator. And if anyone could not create, he could not be ilah. He could not be God. He could not be the God, if you want to use this term. Okay? He said, indeed, those you call in them, other than Allah, they could not create a fly. Okay? Even if they get together. This three challenges here, okay? All one line, one verse, but three challenges here. Are they gods or God or not? Now you call the Mother Nature or the black man or Jesus or whosoever that you look up to them to be as a God and authority. Not only powerful to bring the rain and cause life and death, okay? But also they have the right to legislate. This is something very important. Legislation is the right of Allah. It's the right of the Creator. It's not the right of a human being. Okay? So Allah say, those you invoke them other than Allah, those you calling them and see them to be authority in your life, لَنْ يَخْلُقُ ذُبَابًا. This number one. They could not create a fly. Number two, he said, even if they get together, okay? Even if they get together. So as individual or as a society, as a country or countries, as a superpower or superpowers, okay? Okay, can bring as example Russia, China, and America. So not China by itself, neither China and Russia and America can what? Can create a fly. Subhanallah. And this it shows you that they are not Ilah. They are not God. Not Jesus. Neither the mother nature. And what is the third challenge here that Allah say a fly? Something so small. So small. Whosoever the people calling other than Allah to prove to them that they are not Ilah, they are not God, ask them, create a fly. Challenge them with this verse. You see, you don't have to read the whole Quran. Only one verse in the Quran is showing you Allah and His power and His mighty. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not challenge him to create an elephant, only a fly. And Allah challenged them to create if they are true gods. And He told them also that you are as individual or collective, that you are weak, you could not. Okay? In the continuation of the verse, saying, وَإِن يَسْلُبُهُمُ الذُّبَابُ شَيْئًا لَا يَسْتَنْقِذُهُ مِنْهُ. This number four here. And if the fly takes away something from them, they could not get it back from the fly. You see the weakness. How a person can be a god or gods and they could not even get back something a fly take away from them. We're not talking about China, okay? Taking a piece of land from Russia. No, we're talking about a little small thing that will take something from them. They could not get it back. People fighting, killing each other with thousands and millions. Countries are killing countries. Okay? Over nonsense. Only want to be the superpower or be whatever, and after this he call it you what? We're doing, he's going for duties. He's doing his job. I've been ordered, I've been commanded. This is the problem when the people take the people as gods in their life. Doesn't matter, your commander, your leader told you to kill, so you're going to kill, doesn't matter. They are right or wrong. Oh, they have a nuclear bomb. They have their nuclear weapon. So, everybody have a nuclear weapon. And if somebody have it, but he did not transgress against you, so what? Why you can have it and somebody else could not have it? You see? But they have to make excuse how to can kill other people so they have license to kill. It's okay to kill, but nobody else kill. And after this, they call others to be terrorists. they are not terrorists. Why? Because you are terrorist when you kill one or two or 20. But when you kill 20,000 and half million, you are not terrorist. Because you have license to kill. Who gave you the license? Your selfishness, your greed, that you feel it, that you are a ilah, that you are a god. This was happening nowadays. This was happening, exactly. People have license to kill, and they make an excuse why to kill. All right? See the beauty of Islam? Give you a clear aqidah, a clear understanding about the ilah, the one that everybody have to obey, everybody have to listen, so people can live in peace. And gives you the dalil and the clear evidence that partnership is falsehood. Look in Surah Al-Anbiya as example. In Surah Al-Anbiya, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, لَوْ كَانَ فِيهِمَا آلِهَةٌ إِلَّا اللَّهُ لَفَسَدَتَ فَسُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَرْشِ عَمَّا يَصِفُونَ. If there is other aliha, that mean in the sky and on the land, we have this main two units, or what you call them, planet, okay? You got the skies above you, you got the land under you. If there is other gods beside Allah, they will be spoiled, they will be corrupted, they could not run smoothly and is in order. It's very simple. See, this was Quran, this is the evidence. Look to the partnership, is going to bring about confusion. This ilah that in the sky, and there is another ilah in the ground. This one want to create this man black, and this ilah wanted to be white. This ilah wants the sun to rise today at 6 o'clock, while the other ilah for some reason wanted to be 7 o'clock. This ilah wanted to be hot today, and the other ilah wanted to be snowing today. What's going to happen? What's going to happen? It's going to be a confusion. It's going to be some kind of an argument. And it started at least disapproval. And after this will be some argument. So one day, sooner or later, okay, will be what? Will be a fight. So what's going to happen? Allah said, لَفَسَدَتَا. These two planets, this the ones that you live in under, on it, and the ones that is above you, will spoil, will be corrupted. Because it's going to be misunderstanding and confusion, as a result of partnership. There is no partnership. There is no equal to Allah. There is no other ilah. So the only reason that things going in order, that because the tawheed, because that ilah, one Allah, one creator, one sustainer, one director to all the things. He can make this tree green and make this tree red and blue. He can make grapes or watermelon. He can make it rain or he can, whatever it is. It's only one ilah. You can see it even in a small unit, husband and wife. Sometimes it happens. There is no perfect marriage. Okay? The husband wants to do this and the wife wants something different. Even if she did not fight over it, she's going to understand, making face the whole day. And she will know how to make him understand. Yeah, I'm not going to do anything, but I'm showing. And it can go for a day, and 3 days can go for a week. And after this, we'll start to understand, be something about it. Okay? So subhanAllah, see how Allah given us the guidance and give us the right way to think and to prove to the people that there is no Son and Father and the Holy Ghost. So which one have more power? Huh? Which one? How they can be three and they have equal, okay, power and mighty? And which one you want to please? The Son, or the Father, or the Holy Ghost? Oh, they are not three, but they are one. So how one can be three? Subhanallah. Listen to the next verse, Surah number 17, verse 111. That means 111 or 111. Whatever way, I'm only trying to see if he's still awake or not. Some people may be in Amman and some people sitting in the mosque. You don't know. Some people is a day, night, and night, day. Is it right, Ahmed?
Yeah.
And some people can be in Bangladesh, some people can be in Sudan, in Syria, in wherever, okay? But is Surah number 17, verse what?
111.
No, 111.
Yeah, 111.
Oh, okay. So 111. Listen. قول الله وقول الحمد لله سبحان الله. Do you know we were talking about what in the khutbah yesterday? About Thanksgiving. Okay? Give the thanks here Allah and say Alhamdulillah. When we say Alhamdulillah? When? Huh? When? All time. But when we usually come and you do it what? When you're receiving something. When you've been blessed with something. So now we doing it for the greatest favor and the greatest blessings. And Allah is saying to us, say Alhamdulillah. Why? Because the Tawheed. And say Alhamdulillah that He did not adopt a son. You have the verse? وَقُلِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ. Say it, read it please.
Say, praise be to Allah, who begets no son,
mm-hmm,
and has no partner, mm-hmm, in his dominion.
La ilaha illallah. And he doesn't have a wali.
And
minazul,
nor needs he any to protect him from humiliation.
Uh-huh.
Yea, magnify him.
Subhanallah.
His greatness and his
glory. You see. So now, because when you got the Tawheed, and Allah revealing Tawheed, Allah telling you that this, that you want to, you need to say, to praise Allah on this. Because this is the ni'mah that you get to know, La ilaha illallah. Wa qul alhamdulillah alladhi. So why are you praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Because He is one. That He did not have a son. And He did not have a partner. Neither He have to have somebody to assist Him. You understand, or to protect him, fearing the other gods. He doesn't have any of this. No partner, no son, okay? No support, or he need to understand the assistance of anybody. This had deserved for you to say and to act upon Alhamdulillah. Who's this ilah? This ilah is Laysa kamithlihi shay. Who's this God, or this the God that is supposed to be taking him to be your master, your Sayyid, your Ilah? He said in Surah number 42, verse 11, Laysa kamithlihi shay. And pay attention to this word. Nothing. Shay is thing, a thing. Let me ask you something. Is this a thing? Is this a thing?
Yes.
Is this a thing?
Yes.
So, the tree is a thing. Anything you can point to, say this thing there. Okay? So Allah is saying, there is nothing, okay, similar to Him. Nothing. Anything. You see things, but you see the things, whatever it is, if it's an object, if it's a human being, of whatever it is, that Allah is unique, that anything that you see is not, could not resemble Allah in any fashion or any form, shape or form, like Brother Hassan used to be always saying the word shape or form. Okay? ليس كمثله شيء. There is nothing, nothing can be. Not the stars, not the moon. So do not adopt any of these things that you see or that you touch or you know about it. Don't utter it or make a similarity between it and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because He is unique in everything. And this is what made Him to be the Ilah, the God, the one that worthy of our worship. We want to stop here for this morning, inshallah. We thank Allah for the Tawheed, and we pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among the people who really understand the Tawheed and act upon it. Ameen. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. Any question, any comments, any concern? No, leave the concern after we close the lecture. Anybody have anything about what been said this morning? Sound good? Brother Ahmed, you may hit the button now. Jazakallah khair.